now call the June 9th, 2015 Board of Supervisors meeting back to order from recess. We have Mr. Chad Duffer of All Nation Church here to do the invocation, but I'd like everybody to rise and remain standing for the pledge.
Thank you. Before I pray, just let me thank you all for your community service and to our county. Let's ask the Lord's presence here tonight. Father, thank you for men like this who are willing to serve and make our community what it is. I invite your presence here tonight as they deliberate and do their work. You give them wisdom, bless their families,
and I'll call the
bless our communities, and bless our county.
Board of Supervisors meeting back to order from recess.
Amen.
We have Mr. Chad Duffer of All Nation.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let's ask the Lord's presence here tonight. Thank you. For men like this who are willing to serve and make our community what it is. I invite your presence here tonight as they deliberate and do their work. You give them wisdom, bless their families, bless our communities, and bless our county. In the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Showing the water that comes toward my back door.
Again, welcome.
Every time it rains more, they call me by the inch, inch and a half. Took about a month to get my first phone call back from the Speedwell area. They told me that that wasn't their district, even though I live in the Speedwell district, so that was a little confusing. I did not receive a call back from anybody else. The pictures, I'm going to go ahead and give those to you guys while I'm talking. Somebody from VDOT to give me a call. They called me yesterday, and they pretty much told
some
me
of those pictures that you're
going to
see is showing the water that comes
and
toward
that they
my
really
back
do
door
about it
every time
door.
It rains more than probably about an inch
really
and a half.
I don't really know how to take that answer.
I
was very
called VDOT.
About that.
Took about a month to get my first phone call back from the Speedwell area. They told me that that wasn't their district, even though I live in the Speedwell district, so that was a little confusing. I did not receive a call back from anybody else. I called Soleil. He was very helpful in getting
the last
somebody from VDOT to give me a call. They called me yesterday, and
the water that's coming to
they pretty much told me that that's how the natural flow of water went, and that they really couldn't do anything about it coming to my back door.
In the bottom of my house.
I don't really know how to take that answer. I was very upset yesterday about that. We've replaced gravel twice at my house.
Thought it was a one-time thing.
Moves it all the way down in the creek. Takes it completely away. You can see in the pictures there. My pipe is completely exposed.
Past time happened about two.
We have to dig up my yard.
So
my husband literally has to build a dam to keep it from my back door. The last time it rained so hard, it took seven of us to keep it from coming
in. Somebody else's property.
So the water that's coming to the back of the house that gets to it before we can do our stuff to it is actually deteriorating the outside in the bottom of my house.
Water
exactly the
what did,
water issue really didn't occur until about 4 years ago.
Is
when we first got flooded. Thought it was a one-time thing. It was very rare. It came rushing over
and
very
I
quickly.
Make sure that it's
and
taken care of.
Then this past time happened about 2.5 years later. So I just, we've lived there almost 8 years now, almost probably going on 9. We've never had the issue before. And there was a new drain pipe put in on somebody else's property. Up the hill from us towards Ben Mountain, and it's right above like the pump house, and it comes down through there. And I don't know if that helped with the excess water or exactly what that did, but I don't know how to fix it. I don't own Barrett Mill Road or the pipe, but at the same time, I do own my house, and I want to make sure that it's taken care of. So I wanted to bring that to you all to see what you could do to help us with that, because I'm kind of at a stopping point now. I'm not sure where else to go, but I don't want my house to be washed away either.
I asked him if the pipe broke or the road broke, who would fix it, and he said they would.
I think he's actually here. I'm not sure of his name, to be quite honest.
I don't understand why that doesn't fall under that. Because all it needs is a berm.
I talked to him yesterday.
From the pipe.
Okay, I apologize. I'm not sure of his name.
And we would never have
he
problem.
Just, I actually had a call back, and he picked up the phone. I don't remember him telling me a name.
Is the water coming from VDOT right away or VDOT?
Well, I don't know. For the gentleman that told me yesterday said no, but he's, I asked him if the pipe broke or the road broke, who would fix it, and he said they would. So if the pipe in that road are causing me damage, I don't understand why that doesn't fall under that. Because all it needs is a berm dug from the pipe to the creek that runs beside of my house, and we would never have a problem.
Anybody an opportunity? If Ms. Russell signed up, you'd like to come in and speak. Willing to just talk with Amanda and see if you're not on both citizens' time or VDOT's responsibility for the next item on the agenda is the approval of the minutes for the previous meeting from May 26, 2015.
I make a motion we approve the minutes as presented.
I have a second.
Second.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Russell. I have a motion, a second.
Thank you.
The last meeting is. There's no one else signed up for citizens' time. I'm going to give anybody an opportunity. If you didn't sign up, if you'd like to come up and speak to the rest of the board, do a roll call vote. Dr. Houseman?
Aye.
You're not on both citizens' time?
Aye.
The chair votes aye. Next item on the agenda, the approval of the minutes of the previous meeting from May 26, 2015. Second.
I make a motion we approve the minutes as presented.
I have a second. Any invoice?
Second.
Like to question or discuss? I have a motion, a second, to approve the minutes of the last meeting. Is there any discussion or any corrections or changes to be made?
Aye.
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 The chair votes aye. Here now, next item on the agenda.
Aye.
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 Public hearing.
Aye.
The chair votes aye. Next item on the agenda is payment of invoices. Ordinance 96.4.
I make a motion we pay the bills.
Notice of public hearing in compliance with the Code of Virginia.
Second.
And amendment 13.
Pay the invoices.
Supervisor.
Is any invoice that any board member would like to question or discuss?
June 9, 2015, to your public comment. On the follow roll call vote.
Aye.
Amendment.
Aye.
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 Amendment number 4, water use and management ordinance.
Next item on the agenda is the hearing, public hearing.
For amendment number 4.
Amendment number 4 to water use and management ordinance 96.4.
Begin.
Notice of public hearing in compliance with the Code of Virginia and amendment thereto, the Wythe County Board of Supervisors conducted a public hearing on Tuesday,
County Administration.
June 9, 2015, to your public comment
and copy of the.
On the following proposed ordinance amended.
Amendment 340 South 6th Street.
Amendment number 4, water use and management ordinance 96.4. The hearing for amendment number 4. To the water and water use and management ordinance 96.4 will be begin at or about 7:05 p.m. and may be continued if necessary. The hearing will be held in the boardroom of the County Administration Building, 340 South 6th Street, Wythe, Virginia. A copy of the proposed amendment is on file at the County Administration Office located at 340 South 6th Street, Wythe, Virginia. Or online at www.wythecode.org.
Increase in water rates with County Board of Supervisors. The proposed public hearing to give.
I had no one sign up
by the Wythe County Public Water System an opportunity to comment.
Anybody like to speak?
Change in accordance with the Code of Virginia, section 15.2-2119. And
here none. I'll close the public hearing.
The Wythe County Board of Supervisors proposed a change in the rate charged for water services.
Current rate
$18.
Item is public hearing.
Gallons.
Notice of public hearing proposed increases in water rates with County Board of Supervisors. The proposed public hearing to give the citizens served by the Wythe County Public Water System an opportunity to comment on the proposed rate change in accordance with the Code of Virginia, section 15.2-2119, and subsequent revisions. The Wythe County Board of Supervisors proposed a change in the rate charged for water services. Current rate is $18 for 0 to 1,000 gallons, and $9 per 1,000 gallons after.
proposed rate of is $18.90 for 0 to 1,000 gallons. $9.45.
One person who is in the Blackfoot District called and told me that they cannot be here tonight, but wanted me to make a statement for him.
That's Ms. Sharon King. May be continued if necessary. The public hearing will be held.
Board to know that she very much against any increase in water.
340 South Sixth Street, Wythe, Virginia. I again have no one signed up, but I will give anybody the opportunity if they would like to come up and speak on the public hearing. Hearing none, I'll close the public.
Mr. Chairman, one person who is in the Blackfoot District called and told me that they cannot be here tonight, but wanted me to make a statement for him. And it's Ms. Sharon King. She said that she wanted the board to know that she's very much against any increase in water rates.
I think you have before you two proposed plans.
Turn the water rate increase.
According to which way you all decide to go.
Hearing none, I'll close the public hearing.
One plan, we have added some rural rustic projects to the.
And continue on with the agenda, old business. That VDOT 6-year plan. Mr. Russell.
Two sections on New Bethel. Project on Crawford Road, Major Graham's Road, good evening, and Nixon Road.
Good evening.
The other plan, I think you have before you two proposed plans. Road being.
According to which way you all decide to go.
And as we've discussed at prior meetings. One plan, we have added some rural rustic projects to the proposed 6-year plan, and they included.
On Greasy Creek.
And I had them rerun the estimates. Two sections on New Bethel.
If we didn't
project
even
on
build
Crawford
the bridge.
Road, Major Graham's Road,
Road, the cost estimate
and Nixon Road.
Almost $5.4 million for 1.5.
The other plan, I know there was interest
so
in Greasy Creek.
Two plans.
Road
one's
being
got the rural rustic
part
this one. If we put Greasy
we've
Creek
discussed
on
the prior meetings, Greasy Creek cannot be done rural rustically. That being said, the price tag on Greasy Creek, and I had them rerun the estimates. If we didn't even build the bridges, if all we did was hard surface the road, the cost estimates came in at almost $5.4 million for 1.5 miles of that road. So I'm presenting two plans. One's got the rural rustic. This one, if we put Greasy Creek on, there's certainly no allocation there to add any other roads.
Any questions for Mr. Russell?
Chairman, I will move that we adopt the plan that is the rural rustic option. And if there's a second, I'll explain why in just a minute.
I'll second that. Okay, I have a motion and a second. Adopt. I'll open up the board for discussion of the plan. Motion.
Well, I had, had originally said that I agreed with Gene, and I think that Gene probably is coming from the same place I am now too. That,
Mr. Chairman,
we adopt the plan.
We didn't realize
that it was rusty as option. Costly.
And we had, if there's a second, Anderson I'll explain here why. Just a minute.
And I think that even they, once they heard the price tag, understood that it would be very hard to
to do Greasy Creek Road. And,
well, yeah, and we were,
I had, you know, had originally said that, you know, I agreed with Gene, and I think that Gene probably,
Gene, I hope you
coming from the same place I am now, too.
I agree with you 100%. I'm still going to vote against it.
Yeah, we had said that we would have Greasy Creek on there.
Right.
We didn't realize that it was going to be as costly.
We could do a whole lot more roads.
We had, you know, Mr. and Mrs. Anderson here that night, and I think that even they, once they heard the price tag, understood.
And I know that,
that it would be very hard.
We kind of had the same situation.
To do Greasy Creek.
Not exactly the same situation with Johnny Lane. It had to be.
Yeah, and we are, but we're charged with doing the best we can for most citizens as Greasy Creek. And I think that Greasy Creek involved buying.
So, Gene, I hope you don't disagree with me.
I agree with you 100%. I'm still going to vote against it for the simple fact that.
Mr. Chairman, that's why I made the motion.
Original seven that voted to put it on back in its right order. But I agree. I mean, we can do a whole lot more roads doing it real rustic than we can by trying to abide by what those seven board members at that time agreed to.
And I know that a few years ago, we kind of had the same situation. Well, not exactly the same situation with Johnny Lane. It had to be a project, but it was not nearly as massive as Greasy Creek. And I think that Greasy Creek involves buying one or two homes to try to get it even. So, Mr. Chairman, that's why I made the motion I did.
No.
Okay. And Chair votes aye. Any other comments or questions or discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
A motion and a second.
I guess to be more specific.
Resolution.
Resolutions from.
On.
2015-14.
Amendment six-year plan.
Adding 17.
The rural rustic roads.
20-15-13 really need a separate motion for each one of those. It can be entered in the record and in the minutes of the board package.
Okay, well, then Chair votes aye. Motion passes. Motion for resolution 15-13.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
I'll make a motion to accept that.
I guess to be more specific, the resolutions from 2015-14.
Through 2015-17.
And 20-15-13 really need a separate motion for each one of those so that it can be entered into the record and in the minutes of the board package.
Okay, well,
I'll amend my motion.
Motion for resolution 15-13. I have a second.
I'll second.
I'll make a motion to accept that resolution.
I have a second. Hearing none, I'll be roll call vote.
Mr. Chairman, I would question my word change on the last sentence of that. It says as presented at the public hearing.
Okay, we have resolution 15-14.
As approved.
Motion to approve.
Six-year plan is approved by the board.
I have a second. Mr. Hall, will you amend your motion?
Discussion.
Yeah, I'll amend my motion to change the wording to as approved at the at tonight's meeting.
I have a second.
I'll second.
Resolution, any discussion or comments? 15. I have a motion to approve. Hearing none, I'll do a roll call vote. Dr. Hausman.
Aye.
Aye.
Motion second approved. Okay, we have resolution 2015-14. Any questions for motion as approved?
I move it. We approve.
We have a second. Comments or discussion? Votes aye. Resolution 2015-16. The roll call vote. Mr. Horn. Motion to approve. Resolution 2015-15. Motion to approve. Resolution 2015-16. Have a second.
Second.
Hearing none, I'll be roll call vote. Second to approve resolution 2015-15. Any questions or discussion? Chair votes aye. Hearing none.
Resolution.
We'll roll call vote. Chair votes aye.
Second.
Resolution 2015-16.
Motion to second.
Motion to approve. Resolution 2015-17.
So moved.
Discussion or comments?
Have a second.
Second.
Hearing none. Motion to second. Approve resolution 2015-16. Any discussion? Resolution 2015-8.
Roll call vote.
Mr. Horton.
Aye.
Aye.
Have a second.
Aye.
Second. Have a motion. Resolution 2015-7. Resolution 2015-8.
Motion to approve.
Comments?
Chairman, I make a motion.
Have a second.
Second.
Hearing none, a motion and a second to approve. Resolution 2015-17.
Aye.
Any discussion or comments? Resolution 2015-19.
Roll call vote.
Dr. House.
Aye.
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 The chair votes aye. Resolution 2015-18. Have a motion to approve. Resolution 2015-19. Have a second. Any discussion or comments? Have a motion and a second approved. Resolution 2015-18.
Aye.
Questions?
Aye.
The chair votes aye. Hearing none, a little roll call vote. Mr. Horton.
Aye.
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 The chair votes aye. Resolution 2015-19.
On the agenda, we have a motion to approve.
Feeding boards. Have a second. Have a motion and a second to approve. Resolution 2015-19.
I'm Scott Schwartz. I think most of y'all know me with feeding boards.
Any discussion or comments?
You're y'all's consultant for the Progress Park West Connector Road.
Hearing none.
Just coming in tonight, give y'all an update of where we stand.
Aye.
The latest development was our dedicated public meeting on May the 6th. We had a good turnout. A lot of people came out with three primary comments that I saw and judging by. The first one was really public legacy, increased communication for these future meetings, anything else to be decided on, judging by the people. That's come around, so it's good to see as well. There were one of the other comments with a desire to minimize splitting. We are y'all's consultant for Progress Park West Connector Road. Third one was just coming in tonight, give y'all an update of where we stand. The latest development was our dedicated public meeting on May the 6th. And also had a good turnout. A lot of people came out with three primary comments that I saw. And judging by narrowing down. First one was really public legacy, increased communication for these future meetings, anything else we'd like to go to be decided on, judging by the people that have shown up, it appears that's come around, so it's good to see as well. Southern corridor would allow. One of the other comments was a desire to minimize splitting the properties with the new road. Shorter route. And a third one was a desire from the public to see more concrete design plans. Minimal impact. What land would be required for the right-of-way, easements, and also stormwater management. Which is leading me into the reason I've come here tonight with the update. Anything that goes in. We would like to proceed with narrowing down the area to more of a corridor section. Going on. Instead of the three alternatives we have, we'd like to go with the southern corridor. Y'all can see it in the. Kind of try and lock things down a little bit. White area is kind of the corridor we're looking at. Southern corridor would allow, and I believe y'all have a sketch of this in your packet. The one we propose is 3A. That area would allow for a shorter route from the park to the Pepper Spray Road interchange. It would allow for minimal impacts to Pepper Spray Road. Now, again, I don't want to discount this because everything, I think everyone knows the problems with the interchange there at Pepper Spray Road. All these alternatives. Anything that goes in with the Progress Park Road is going to ultimately result in some significant improvements going on at the interchange there and Nye Road as well. With going with that southern alternative, y'all can see it in the white area is kind of the corridor we're looking there. Some storage for the purple line. Is the one we propose is 3A. And one of the results from the comments was some people would like to see what's shown up there as the green line, which is going south of the existing AEP power line corridor. Splitting it, in essence. Again, as I stated, all these things are, all these alternatives are going to require significant improvements to the interchange area. But by moving it south to Nye Road, you're going to limit it to just that interchange area and not have to push it out further on Pepper Spray Road. I don't know if this requires board action. This corridor would also allow some storage for traffic on Nye Road. Again, taking it off by creating a separate. Isolating it down to that corridor. Corridor, separate alignment from the park to the interchange area, separating it from Pepper Spray Road. You're not having to deal with that traffic along Pepper Spray Road. Being able to identify better. Splitting it, in essence. Any environmental issues that are out there, historic. if acceptable to the board, we'd like to discuss.
If y'all will admit us, our recommendation again would be to study the southern corridor and basically remove alternatives 1 and 2 from consideration.
Lover's Lane, it's been significant.
I don't know if this requires board action or if.
Reroute around.
Me just coming here and telling you that's the way we're going to proceed.
Also, if there's any historic.
Right now, that's our plan.
Any cemeteries.
By isolating it down to that corridor allows us to proceed with getting the designs a little bit tighter, being able to identify storage areas for stormwater, being able to identify better any environmental issues that are out there, historic. If acceptable to the board, we'd like to discuss with the property owners out there any environmental issues they may have, if they know of existing streams. Obviously, one of the things that came up last time in the meeting was spraying along Lover's Lane. It's been a significant concern to the public. So we can identify that, reroute around those as possible.
It's just.
Also, there's any historic elements out there, any cemeteries or anything identified on people's properties that we need to relocate around.
Any environmental areas that, you know, the public has desired that.
That's really all I have, so y'all have any questions?
Expressed their interest on. We move forward and can look at that from an environmental standpoint. Are there streams out there we need to avoid? Where exactly is that spring, if we can get on people's properties and take a look at that?
The green line, you said, is.
Cemetery on some.
What, get many of the public wanting to see?
We can lock that down.
Correct, yes.
We can better identify.
And by saying the southern corridor, and that's a possibility?
Correct, the southern corridor, as we're identifying it, it's kind of.
It's just an error.
Exactly.
Okay.
We're basically, the purpose is to kind of remove alternatives 1 and 2. And be able to kind of start identifying
the main thing.
Any environmental areas that, you know, the public has desired that green line, a number of people have expressed their interest on. We move forward and can look at that from an environmental standpoint. Are there streams out there we need to avoid? Where exactly is that spring, if we can get on people's properties and take a look at that? I know there was one of the comments was a cemetery on some on one of the properties out there. We can lock that down. We can better identify what land may be needed.
And that more closely follows property lines?
Correct, I believe, and it's difficult to see on the map.
Correct.
It's tough.
Not just those two lines.
But I believe it's going between two properties, right, as it comes down to 9.
And so putting it in with the least disturbance.
The main thing. We tried to kind of.
Possible.
Go between property lines and not split properties as much as possible.
Okay.
Do we have to take board action on that? Okay, does anyone on the board?
I believe in the VDOT Land Use Manual. Take the next step. They have presented. Public hearing comment.
Two routes, the green and purple.
Make a recommendation on the corridor study and you need to take action.
You're talking about looking at the area between the white lines?
Correct, yes. Not just those two alignments, but basically that swath.
All right, and so putting it in with the least disturbance?
Correct.
Possible, okay.
Do you have to hold a public hearing or just? Well, they'll have to take action on that.
They accept the environment. I believe in the VDOT Land Use Manual to take the next step. They have to present the public hearing comments. Preferred route. Make a recommendation on the corridor to study and you need to take action.
I entertain a motion. We don't have to take any action right now.
I think you have to accept that recommendation for the court.
Okay. Entertain a motion to accept Pete Morton's recommendation. And hold, we have to hold a public hearing or just, well, they'll have to get the information together to hold a public hearing.
They accept the environmental impact analysis is the way I'm understanding this. Those routes and select a preferred route out of this corridor.
For a discussion. James?
Well, I mean, we're just looking at it. I mean, we're not saying right now it's going there.
Right, nothing's in stone.
I think you have to accept that recommendation for the court.
Because I haven't talked to the people out there, so I don't know.
Entertain a motion to accept Pete Morton's recommendation.
I think they need to have some input in it. I mean, I know if it was going through the middle of my farm.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Well, some of the comments that we read were certainly so that land wouldn't be split, that it would be better if it went along property lines, which gives you the option in this.
Well, I mean, we're just looking at it. I mean, we're not saying right now it's going there.
Right. Nothing's in stone.
That was the preferred section was to put it in there instead of. I mean, because I haven't talked to the people out there, so I don't know how it's affected them. I think they need to have some input in it. I mean, I know if it was going through the middle of my farm, I'd like to have input.
The comments that I read. Some of the comments that we read were certainly so that land wouldn't be split, that it would be better if it went along, you know, property lines, which gives you the option in this.
Follow the property line as much as possible, so that...
And I mean, I may be wrong, but I mean, the way I read the comments that we had was that that was the preferred section, was to put it in there instead of, to take the other two routes completely out. I mean, is that what you took from the public comment that you got?
We'll be back, but...
The comments that I read, I think, you know, the concerns were, you know, splitting land.
Right.
I don't know if we really have one planned right now.
Spring out there that's used, and of course, I don't know where that is.
And we'll obviously approach the property before you go out.
The other was to follow the property line as much as possible, so that...
A lot of times, property lines, y'all know, will go right down hollow.
Would be coming from, you know, from two property owners.
If it's wet, you're looking at a lot more environmental issues. So it may not be the wise thing to hold that green line the whole way down. We need to look at that. And even though it may show it on topo maps, we'll be back. Big difference, like I said, there could be a spring out there we're not seeing on the topo maps. It's a big difference when you're environmental issues. Also cemeteries, historical...
I don't know if we really have one planned right now. I'd like to
put some boots on the ground out there and kind of walk those areas.
And we'll obviously approach the property owners before we go out there.
Honestly, I don't really know.
Some of those areas, a lot of times, property lines, y'all know, will go right down hollows. And if that, based on my ability to get out there, is wet, you're looking at a lot more environmental issues. So it may not be, you know, a wise thing to hold that green alignment the whole way down. We need to look at that, get out there. And even though it may show it on topo maps, which we've seen, it's a big difference, like I said, there could be a spring out there we're not seeing on the topo maps. It makes a big difference when you're environmental issues. Also cemeteries, historical issues. Once we get that kind of locked down, we can kind of proceed with showing the stormwater areas where we think those go and locking down a good alignment. Honestly, I don't really know right now. I would speculate at least 2 months for another public hearing, based on my ability to get out there. And it takes time to get property owners access as well.
We've got the engineer and our engineer. I'd prefer that they did.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Mr. Bond, to approve P and Board's recommendation.
I'll go through it real quick. I'm going to try and read it because I don't know all the numbers off the top of my head. We opened bids June the 2nd. We opened them in staggered bid format this time, which was allowing, divided them into three sections in the hope for some of the smaller contractors to be able to get them. And then by staggering the bids, opening the first one, 2 o'clock, the next one, 3, I'm sorry, next one, 2:30, following one, 3, and then 3:30 for the final one.
We've got the engineer and our engineer. I prefer that they did.
And actually, we think we got some lower prices, so it worked out in our favor. We did get three relatively small contractors.
I'm going to try and read it because I don't know all the numbers off the top of my head. We opened bids June the 2nd. We opened them in staggered bid format this time, which was allowing, divided them into three sections in the hope for some of the smaller contractors to be able to get them. And then by staggering the bids, opening the first one, 2 o'clock, the next one, 3, I'm sorry, next one, 2:30, following one, 3, and then 3:30 for the final one. Allowed them to adjust their bids. And actually, we think we got some lower prices, so it worked out in our favor. We did get three relatively small contractors, Little B out of Castlewood, Virginia. I'm not familiar with them, but I believe Mr. Dalton is aware.
Budget-wise, we came in...
Meade Contracting out of Pulaski. Doug Meade did the Route 619 job for us probably 3 or 4 years ago now. Did a good job. He's well-known, again, a small contractor. And the third contract went to, or will hopefully be awarded to, Central Contracting, which is Cherokee, who's currently doing Barron Springs Phase 1. He's right on time, and it's actually a little bit ahead of schedule on that one. He did Speedwell along Route 21 as well, and actually has another job pending with the county for some improvements in the radio drive tank. Budget-wise, we came in quite well. We are, I believe, about $190,000 below the total budget, so that'll be left in contingency. And basically just asking for the board's approval or allowance to give the contractor notice of award and move forward with it. Get those people in Barron Springs some water.
I did a quick bid analysis based on the historical water projects we've done over the last 5 years. Inflated those costs to 2015. Found out that the first project, 2A,
was a little bit below the first standard deviation of the historical average, which meant we got really good bids on that, which would not be unexpected. The most difficult part of that project is crossing Schwartz Creek, the rest is pretty much straight waterline installation. And one piece being pretty much a dirt road, so construction would be easy. The next two projects are in difficult sections. We have everything fair enough to pass on the 2D cross road, which is stream on either side as well as a lot of in the road work. That project was right at the first standard deviation to the right, meaning a little more than the average, but not unexpected, given that average deviation.
So all three bids, first of the very favorable difficulties that are anticipated, and that was
between the bids we received, the contractors realized this is all being about sections, so those two facts gave me a warm fuzzy. Same thing with the third section. It's going up wiser, which means it's a primary road, so you're going to have a little more control there, a little more difficulty with construction. And then going up to the water tank on Swickertown, it's a very sinuous road. Probably going to have several crossings of the road if we have to, depending on how the borderline has to go in there. A little more difficult construction, also to the right of the average. But given the construction difficulty.
I did forget the tank job. It was all contracts for that. The tank contractor is King General Contractors out of Bristol, Virginia. They're actually the contractor to do the site work for the last job, Speedwell, Grayson Road Tank. But they're going to be the general on this one, and they're going to be getting the same tank we put in Speedwell, which is the same tank we have out at Rural Retreat as well.
And since we still have money left for contingency.
Some modifications on this tank, a recirculation, to try and hopefully minimize some of the issues we have out. Radio drive.
Expect to have a lot of contingency because they've already bid in that direction.
Again, good bids and good contractors.
Okay, does anyone have any questions for Bill?
Okay.
I did forget the tank job completely. I apologize for that one. The tank contractor is King General Contractors out of Bristol, Virginia. They're actually the contractor to do the site work for the last job at Speedwell, Grayson Road Tank. But they're going to be the general on this one, and they're going to be getting this same tank we put in at Speedwell, which is the same tank we have out at Rural Retreat as well. Going to be putting in some modifications on this tank, a recirculation, to try and hopefully minimize some of the issues we have out the radio drive tank with the turnover on that. Again, good bids and good contractors.
Okay. Mr. Dawson, we take all this up and want to the bottom.
I would just accept the bid recommendation or bid tabulation and revised budget that's shown on page
29-57.
Mr. Chairman, I'll make that motion.
I'll second. Second.
If any of you have any agenda items you'd like to see.
Motion, second, set.
Discuss that night. If you'll get them to us, we'll forward them over to the town with them.
Any questions or comments? Hearing none, I'll do a roll call vote. Mr. Horny?
Aye.
The chair votes aye. Next item on the agenda is the joint governing body meeting. Next item on the agenda is June
29th, on a Monday night.
It's on page 113.
7 o'clock. If any of you have any agenda items you'd like to see, we'll discuss that night. If you'll get them to us, we'll forward them over to the town with them.
Accept settlement for service.
Be board member wants anything to add on the
courthouse roof job. $500 for the courthouse as a penalty.
Time on that before you price. Get it to the town.
Kind of get it.
Next item on the agenda is the building grounds committee.
Approved by the committee.
It's on page 113. The committee doesn't need a second. Any questions?
I'm going from memory.
Discussion.
Accept the settlement for service roofing on.
Agenda is the
courthouse roof job.
County Creek Court of Court. The governor has sent a letter
on the adjustment price.
That we provide
$4,500 credit for the overrun on time.
That Christmas tree is
by the committee.
County, okay, come from the committee. Doesn't need a second. Any questions? Cities too. Discussion. We need to roll call vote. Dr. Hausman.
I would advertise on the radio.
Agenda is the Baco in the county tree ornament. The governor has sent out a letter to us requesting that.
And for those ornaments that are not selected, those will be
Placed on the Christmas tree.
Christmas tree is counties and localities. It ain't on counties, it's towns and cities too.
They want TVS for adults too, because they're thinking about doing.
We need to.
Future for kids, Christmas ornaments.
How do we do this? A competition or a?
I would advertise on the radio and.
What kind of time limit?
In the paper that will provide prize money to the best ornament. And for those ornaments that are not selected, those will be placed on the Christmas tree at the county courthouse. We'll just do that and take.
And this is, they wanted to keep this for adults too, because they're thinking about.
What was the price?
In the future for kids, Christmas ornaments.
You name it, we'll do it.
I want to know what we're going to pay for something before I vote to do it, so.
What kind of time limit? I mean, they have to have these in, I can't remember.
Neighborhood.
Last contest we ran was Progress Park. I think we paid $200 as the winning price.
Do we need that in a motion or inclusive?
If that's consensus, we'll just do that. Put an advertisement and get on the radio and.
And a pack of nabs if it's a little.
See if we can get that going in some church groups.
What was the price?
You name it, we'll do it.
I want to know what we're going to pay for something before I vote to do it.
Okay, moving right along, we have the proposed Wythe County comprehensive plan.
$200, neighborhood again.
Last contest we ran was Progress Park. I think we paid $200.
If y'all read it, and then let's set the date at the next meeting.
All inclusive trip to the board, man. And a pack of nabs if it's a little speedy.
Is that the board's consensus, but we move forward with that?
Yeah.
I hear nobody say no.
That's consensus of the board.
Okay, moving right along, we have the proposed Wythe County comprehensive plan set for public hearing. When you want to set it, at the next meeting?
Let's set, if y'all read it.
Yes, sir.
And then let's set the date at the next meeting.
Several weeks ago.
The South, just be back on the agenda for SREC over there, which we were part of, our small business incubator, decided to close the doors as part of that.
Amendment request.
Dissolving, all the money that was in the bank was split based off your shares. We received a check for $25,807.61. Our previous recommendation to this board was that we give that.
Several weeks ago, the South.
Own the small business.
CIRCAP for SREC over at, which we were part of, our small business incubator, decided to.
2 days a week, I think it is, in Wythe County.
Close the doors.
Every other week over in Bland.
As part of that, this is dissolving between all the money that was in the bank.
We have enough money.
Based off your shares.
For next year, we won't need any money.
We received a check for $25,807.61. Our previous recommendation to this board was that we give that to CRIFA.
And we would a lot of businesses.
Hire our own small business person that would help people divide, prepare business plans, but he would be. Spend 2 days a week, I think it is, in Wythe County, and 1 day every other week over in Bland. And this money between.
I'll make that motion.
Bland, Wythe, and Wythe, we have enough money.
I'll second.
That this year, or next year, we won't need any money to hire this person. And we'll evaluate that next year's budget.
Here now, we'll roll call vote.
He has done, or he or she, the person's done a good job. And helped a lot of businesses, then CRIFA will fund that in the future.
Okay, Mr. Dalton, does any other business come forward to board at this time?
Okay, we have a recommendation.
We did get a letter from the town of Wythe today about.
Amend and appropriate.
Proposed routing of.
$25,807.61 to CRIFA.
Park.
I have a motion.
VDOT.
I'll make that motion.
Have a second.
In a sketch months ago of a proposed route.
Motion is second. Floor up for discussion.
Out to the park.
Here now, we'll roll call vote.
Proposed.
Aye.
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 Would take
significant portion of Lot 24and not get to the center of the park.
Okay, Mr. Dawkins, any other business come forward at this time?
We did get a letter from the town of Wythe today about the proposed routing of the park that VDOT had sent in a sketch months ago of a proposed route from Exit 70.
To Exit 41 from VDOT.
Out to the park. That's the reason that proposal ended up VDOT suggesting to look at that route. A significant portion of Lot 24 and not get to the center of the park.
Reply to VDOT.
So that was, plus we, what we had in our hands, we had for all the letter from VDOT to that day said that they would improve Exit 41. We did not have any commitment from VDOT to look at Exit 70 or any commitment.
I'd be more than happy.
Our funding was to study a route to Exit 41 from VDOT. That's the reason that proposal was VDOT's suggestion to look at that route. We would have to start back square one and reapply to VDOT. We would actually been on the hook for all the money we'd spent up to that date on that court.
And talk, deliberate. Will you be so gracious and kind, right, Mr. Sutherland?
Yeah, right now. I'd be more than happy to go to their meeting and talk.
Okay. Or go with, set up a meeting, we'll go to them.
I do not know that we came to consider better to do it at recess to a certain date, except to meet right now.
Set up a meeting, and I'll be there.
Okay. That everybody had a conflict.
Okay, I know we discussed this about a recess, and did we ever come up with a date?
That was your conflict.
That we were going to recess and talk to start to deliberate.
Can we take just a 5-minute recess? Because I've got right now. Different people.
Okay. We'll be in recess.
I do not know that we came to consensus to recess to a certain date, except to meet right now after this meeting. That everybody had a conflict with every date the rest of June.
We didn't even have Steve here.
I didn't have a conflict.
That was your conflict.
Okay. So we'll start discussing it now, and then we'll.
Can we take just a 5-minute recess, because I've got a pile of papers from different people.
Okay. We'll be in recess for 10 minutes. In recess for a budget work session. Mr. Dalton, you got the floor?
Okay. I think we're all set. The way we've got to do this, and we've got the comments from the public hearing. Based off the comments of the spoken here and everybody, and most everybody was asking that for an extra money. So let's wait until the end and talk about that. We've also through the three public hearings we had, about as required for the law of Virginia, and one was the tax increase, the 5 cents. But the law tells you that about the budget each team developed to use that 5 cent tax. What the law says is they could enact that or lower it. That's a discussion. So you can't lower it. You go through this whole thing and you lower it.
Yes.
And from that point, we're talking about the economy. We go through those discussions. We've also got the balance discussions. The money to lower it. Right. To make the balance budget. It's required. It's required for the law in Virginia to lower it. But then, like Herman, too, it is. Like an opportunity to go through the budget with any recommendations of how you can cut it out.
numbers that where we're at, State Virginia provided 2% raise in this constitutional legislation. Currently, in August or September, we've got school teachers, 2%, it's a little bit of September, $1 million, $295,000. School proposed to do is 2% teachers, all, everybody else, 1.5% administration. Everybody else, $1 million, all, 5% in the same time. But the school, they need $76,000 or $96,000. Currently, we've got 5 cents, which gets you a little bit over $1 million, $245,000. Tax rate, solid waste, state tax, permit.
Okay, we'll talk about the tax increase first.
Buy a permit, that's $360,000.
I haven't heard any, very little comment whatsoever about the tax increase. I saw me, one I did hear, Rob said, raise it another penny or two higher and forget about the trash order. I have on the.
We'll just take notes.
I won't be. Okay, we'll talk about the tax increase first, except the tax, 5 cent tax increase. I haven't heard any, very little comment whatsoever.
I haven't heard anything about that piece.
One I did hear, Rob said, raise it another penny or two higher and forget about the.
At any point.
Trash order.
You know.
The trash thing.
If we weren't to do that.
I have on the.
So for the long-term fiscal responsibility, I don't see how we can.
My vote.
We need to go into reserves, but then wait until next year.
Tax increase.
At some point, I guess the can's got to be. I haven't heard anything about that piece. And I think, I don't think anybody likes a tax increase.
Oh, I don't either, but.
At any point, but, you know, if we weren't to do that, I think you're going to see major adjustments in the budget. So for the long-term fiscal responsibility, I don't see how we can do that. I mean, you could go into reserves, but then wait until next year.
I've had complaints about the trash fee.
At some point, I guess the can's got to be not kicked.
I'm trying to think. I can't remember anybody that's said anything to me about the tax rate.
Well, in fairness, I mean, we did have people at the public hearing that spoke against the tax increase.
We've come to that point.
I think there was 12 people that spoke. Now, a couple people spoke to your point, Tim. Increase it more, mainly for school earmark, I guess, for lack of a better term. And then other people spoke.
I've had complaints about the trash fee.
I mean, Slell, just for discussion, what areas would.
I'm trying to think. I can't remember anybody that's said anything to me about the tax rate.
Well, in fairness, I mean, we did have people at the public hearing that spoke against the tax increase. I think there was 12 people that spoke. Now, a couple people spoke to your point, Tim. Increase it more, mainly for school earmark, I guess, for lack of a better term. And then other people said cut spending. I mean, Slell, just for discussion, what areas would we be able to cut? I mean, that would significantly replace $1+ million.
System.
one entertainer. Eliminate one span, all the quick purchase of some of the staff, road out to the park, go back. You want those big things, I mean, the water and sewer are basically set aside a lot of money. Everything in the sheriff's department almost is paid for police activities running or a special assessment. Basically, we fund the schools and I guess recreation, county administration, some treasury commissioners office, a little bit.
Well, I think you made a good point when you made the presentation. Yeah, that being in the people business, because that is what our resource is, that's what our product is. And there are certain costs associated, you know, with that. So I have to tell you, I'm like everybody else, you know. I would rather not have to raise taxes, but I'm okay with the 5 cent real estate tax. It's at this point it's necessary. Well, I think you made a good point when you made the presentation. Yeah, that being in the people business, because that is what our resource is, that's what our product is. And there are certain costs associated, you know, with that. So I have to tell you, I'm like everybody else, you know. I would rather not have to raise taxes, but I'm okay with the 5 cent real estate tax. Assistant President, I think it's at this point it's necessary.
Bus people, everybody. Unless you're an administrator.
That administrative raise of 1.5%. That's who in the school fees, that all the central office and all the federal.
Central office, principals,
assistant principals. That's basically it. I would think that it's superintendent, and there is no assistant superintendent, so superintendent, the directors, and supervisors. I think they have coordinators. I think the coordinators fall under the teacher scale.
The 1.5%?
Principal, assistant principal, superintendents, finance director, assistant superintendents, director of special education, whatever the higher.
I would think that it's superintendent, and there is no assistant superintendent, so superintendent, the directors, and supervisors. I think if they have coordinators, I think the coordinators fall under the teacher scale.
Okay, then the hard question, how much would we save if we left that same class?
The 1.5%?
I don't want to misunderstand, and here you can, so not, if you don't fund it.
I guess statistically, how we fund it.
These are people that are in the higher tier of pay anyway. The teachers are not in the higher tier of pay unless they're paid the leave on step rate.
So many teachers, when they get to the top level, then they get a match of the raises if there is a raise.
I don't want you to misunderstand Eddie Higgins said here.
I understand the question. Logistically, and how we fund it. What the law says is,
I think what you're saying in a nutshell, Joe, is a 1.5% raise for an administrator is a whole lot more money than a 1% raise for a teacher or.
Well, you know, in our round
up, I did above that, you can line item and
just give it to who you want to.
That's
a pretty drastic change in
my
philosophy. I didn't
afford
a supervisor to raise to do
anything. All I ask is, what is the number? Well, and it would be an estimate, I realize.
Everybody else, there's a step.
I think what you're saying in a nutshell, Joe, is a 1.5% raise for an administrator is a whole lot more money than a 2% raise for a teacher or...
Well, you know, in our budget, I didn't put a raise in this administration, school board, myself. You know, you're going to face a different term, right? So I didn't include any raise for me in this year's budget, because I'm going to be here about the money, 0.5 million, so 1% is the value of this, is 4.5, unless you're...
But there's a raise in there for all department heads and all...
Everybody else, there was a step, increase for everybody else.
I don't agree with math, but...
So, Joe, let's say there...
But we have no idea what any...
11 schools. And let's say there's 10 people at school board that line out of budget. That's the reason I have 30 people, I wouldn't have got 30 people, and I could pull out every administrator. It's 3.5 million, so 1% is 35,000, so it's 1.5 schools plus hours of benefit offers. So $50,000 broken out separately, it's a budget, you might get...
You're right, I don't agree with your math, but I'm going to accept it, because I don't know what I'm talking about. But we have no idea what any...
I guess I'm making far off. No. I agree with that. I can't go through the line out of budget. That's the reason I asked for recess, I wouldn't have got it. And I could pull out every administrator, or most of them, in the budget. Because under high school, supervisors and all of those things, they're broken out separately in this budget.
All I want to understand from my position is that in my career in business, I've always wanted to pay...
You might guess I'm not too far off, Joe.
Surely because our one...
I am, but I apologize.
Well, we know that we've got some things for different reasons, supervisors, you're different, sorry, but that'd be what you make going on.
Yeah, it is, but it's not supervising programs. It's working with people, it's working with the community, it's working with everything. School, you know, it's going to be very difficult for a school to operate, you know, with, you know, without a principal.
In my career in business, I've always wanted to pay the people for the term of life in charge. And school teachers are the one that produce the product.
And the high school principals...
And administrators, total rings, they're supervisors. Jerry, I'm sorry, but that's the way you make your living.
Yeah, it is, but it's not supervising programs. It's working with people, it's working with the community, it's working with everything. School, you know, it's going to be very difficult for a school to operate, you know, with, you know, without a principal.
I agree with that, somebody is in charge.
Joe, in the high school principals, there's three of them in the county, their total raise was $2,800.
Divide by three. When you go with that line item, what if you look at part of the central office?
Fairly confident, if that's not exactly... Now, I'm going to get way out, superintendent, I guess I'll be on the table, and I'll just say it. You know, for a while, you've been the lead's last day, and you're going to be leaving up the superintendent's office for pay. Everybody put them on, consulting, or help.
Is it a done deal that the superintendent, the new superintendent makes what the sitting superintendent makes? He may make less.
Fairly confident, Joe, that that's not, I guess, but it won't. That'd be my guess. If I'm just looking at the superintendent's pay in here, I'm paying for the paper.
Is it a done deal that the superintendent, the new superintendent makes what the...
Because of his years of experience versus what we have?
He may make less.
Well, in my guess, he may make more.
Or just...
That that'd be my guess, $22 deduction from last year's superintendent pay. I didn't see him pay, issue paper or anything, announce superintendent's pay as they do the county. Last year's pay was $128, $122 issue of pay. I guess the new superintendent makes more than those. Maybe wrong.
Because of his years of experience versus what Lee had? Or just the...
There's a $3,100, so if you're saying, Joe, take $22 deduction, then from last year's superintendent's pay, this year's superintendent pay in the proposed last year's pay was $128, $122, this year's pay, they showed $125.
Well, that don't mean it's wrong, it means it's different.
I didn't say it was wrong, I just said it was a different philosophy, that this was prepared to give to you in April before they move on to new superintendent. So if you're saying, Joe, take what's above and decide it, minimum requirements of Atlanta, you have that in mind.
The whole one of the job, but everybody's in their back room.
It's just a different philosophy. We've never had my 21 years here.
Well, I don't think there's principals making $125,000.
It's a different philosophy.
$2,800 between three principals.
I will say this, it's not a lot of money. Whatever you decide, that's what we'll live.
Central office, I don't expect to need a place before it all. 2% raise, you're making $40,000. 2% raise, you're making $25,000.
Well, I don't think there's principals making $125,000.
I'm not picking on principals, they're just... $2,800 between three principals is not a lot of money. But maybe the central office is, it's hard for me to believe there are only 10 people over there, the difference that are in a supervisory position. All the rest of them are covered by 2% raise as teacher help. But it looks like to me there's a lot of helpers over there that are supervisory helpers there. And it all flows back to the superintendent making the big decision.
Don't look at me, I'm not the federal...
Should.
Look at the banker.
Well, I'm...
The difference in the base.
I didn't have anyone.
Doesn't mean that everybody else gets an equal raise and take back. And I appreciate that you said, but... What you're getting water, the branch. It's there, it's in our account.
It's there, yeah, we have...
We didn't have all that.
Don't look at me, I'm not the federal...
Look at the banker.
Well, I'm...
I don't have a trick for kids to come in my store. I never had anyone tax. They don't call me Mr. Mayor, I go in now. Cold. I go in school after they say cold. I've got two of the prettiest schools is in the county, rock to me. I'm getting water, the burns fine, getting dirt roads paved. Got a new gym and shit, it's good. We didn't have all that. So for that nigga, let me add another little thing cost me. Other than that, just to add, just for my kids, I don't have a place to go, just for kids, they come in my store, I look at them every day, they don't call me Mr. Mayor, or she said, cold. I go in the school after they say cold. She said, we won't carry water, you rock to me. She said, we got signs on the wall, thank you, about the drinking water. That'll be taken care of.
Does anybody else have any more comments on the 5% tax increase?
Let me add another little thing.
Okay.
When I come home, I'm happy with my school board. transfer this Wythe, a little Chevy, Jackson Lamar, to vote me out. She said there's one thing I wish you'd work on. I said, what's that?
No, all of us is here to do whatever's best for the county.
She said, we got signs on the wall, man, about the drinking water.
At heart.
You know, that'll be taken care of, but not already.
It's working on.
We're not voting tonight, but it sounds like that piece.
If they don't like my vote for a raise, they can vote me out. Plenty of time to tell you.
I know all of us is here to do whatever's best for the county, and I think all of us has got that.
I'm not hearing any opposition to this piece.
Well, no.
We got a piece here.
At heart.
A little more lively.
Just what's best for the county.
Well, one of the things I'm hearing, nobody wants a tax increase, and I think we're all seven in agreement.
We're not voting on it tonight, but it sounds like that piece was.
And also the trash fee was a little more palatable to a lot of people, because it didn't just affect the landowners. So, I mean, other than one person in Walmart, I'm pretty much hearing that's the most fair way to do it.
I'm not hearing any opposition to this piece.
Well, no.
We got another piece here, but it might be a little more lively.
Well, one of the things I'm hearing, nobody wants a tax increase, and I think we're all seven in agreement with that. But the way we did it this year with the property tax and also the trash fee was a little more palatable to a lot of people, because it didn't just affect the landowners. So, I mean, other than one person in Walmart, I'm pretty much hearing that's the most fair way to do it.
Okay, well, this is what I have.
Well, no, I've had complaints on this one.
I would say I've had some complaints.
Let's move on to the $30 a year.
I haven't heard it exactly like that. I will do it. It's always somebody else is going to do it when I get it, but.
I've heard people do it, they said, I will.
Discussions on this.
I will throw it over the bank.
Which my response is always, well, that's sad, you know, that people would just do that, you know.
Pay $30, throw it.
And the people doing it now, when there is no additional fee, but they're still paying for it out of general fund.
Well, this and I have.
Well, no, I've had complaints on this one.
I would say I've had some complaints on this one as well.
I've heard that more than enough.
I haven't heard it exactly like that. I will do it. It's always somebody else is going to do it when I get it, but.
I've heard people do it, they said, I will do it. I will throw it over the bank.
Which my response is always, well, that's sad, you know, that people would just do that, you know. And there are people doing it now.
I know we have a problem.
When there is no additional fee, but they're still paying for it out of the general fund. I mean, I still see trash.
That's like last night, I was at Farm Bureau meeting, and I talked to a guy that had somebody brought up the thing.
I don't think that's going to change, yeah, a $30 fee or whatever.
And he said, well, it doesn't do any good. He said, because they come through and pick it up, and he said, 2 weeks, it's right back the same way, because he said, it's like people driving down the road and say, well, they can send somebody to pick it up anyway, so I wonder.
Well, I know we have a problem in this county with people throwing trash out.
I think we have a problem in this country.
Well.
Trash out, it ain't just Wythe County, it's everywhere. People just have no respect for nothing.
And I don't think that's going to change if you have a $30 fee or you don't have a $30.
No, I think that the trash cleanup is more.
I think it helps. I mean, you're not going to keep them clean, and you're not going to get all the trash. But I think that there's a whole lot less trash out there on the side of the road than there used to be before you did.
And the
education is the only answer. If we get that program in the schools, that hopefully the insurance department has told us that they're going to make it part of their program. They'll put that in the part of their program, start ADHD, second, third grade, green box.
Most of those vehicles have a farm use tag that they got from the tractor supply. I just figured out.
You could have gone all night.
I had to get that in for Joe. This is going to be my last budget session I had.
Well, there's some proof of it. We ain't able to collect the money. Something I can ask you, your kids to think about, how long the parents, why do you do that? Purchase property tax, whoever they ride with, a lot of it's pulled out of vehicle.
And maybe that's the answer to, but I mean, to Slell, or to, if we say, because the budget now has. And most of those vehicles have a farm use tag that they got from the tractor supply. I just figured out.
You could have gone all night.
I had to get that in for Joe. This is going to be my last budget session I had.
Or
if you go into reserve, you've got to think about next year already coming in with a tax increase to fund. And maybe that's the answer to, but I mean, to Slell's point, or to, if we say, because the budget now has the $30 fee in there, so if we said we're not going to charge the fee, which I think there's a lot of problems in implementing it, same types of things from last year, just, I think it's better this year, but I don't know that it's all the problem. We have to either cut it.
The complaints that I
if you go into reserves, you've got to think about next year already coming in with a tax increase to fund. So,
one other solution,
increase your elections.
Taxes that are due.
Exactly.
We're not collecting those taxes. And there's other taxes that are not being pursued and collected.
Do you think either one of the treasurer candidates, or however many there could be, I guess, they haven't closed yet, or let's go run on, I'm going to do more to collect, I agree with that. I'm going to collect, but, you know, I think that's, I think most people will support that. I mean, people who pay their taxes, when you increase taxes, that's the first thing you point at, is what about Joe Schmo, who's, you know, not paying and not having any repercussions.
Did that guy sign the agreement?
Do you think either one of the treasurer candidates, or however many there could be, I guess, it hadn't closed yet, or I was going to run on, I'm going to do more to collect.
I think it's closed now.
I'm going to collect, but you know, I think most people would support that. I mean, people who pay their taxes. When you increase taxes, that's the first thing you point at, is what about Joe Schmo, who's, you know, not paying and not having any repercussion on it.
I mean, we are trying to collect more delinquent taxes than we used to.
Did that guy sign the agreement, or did he accept it?
Sam's got this contract. All guys gonna work. I'm talking about hard. The process takes about 8 months to be here. We're not getting the big compensation for this collection. Maybe it is for next year, but it's not for this time.
No, and that's not all the order one I'm talking into. You know that. I'm after those people that overpaid the property tax and don't ever get a bill. Less money than before we ran there out there, and there's not 400 of them. There's 1,000 of them in this county that should be paying personal property tax and don't pay.
The man collecting the money working.
I'm talking about car. I'm talking about people that are on the road with new vehicles.
I just passed like that on the board as board supervisor.
We're not getting to those people. The exoneration number is flabbergasting to me. That all the work that's gone into the exoneration.
Is that right?
Is it true that today we raised the rate and have less money than before we raised the rate?
Unfortunately, that is a true state.
Well, that just does not make sense.
Our transient contractor. It does if the man collecting the money is working against you.
The man that's collecting the money has nothing to do with what's being billed. I didn't know till I got on the board that the Board of Supervisors doesn't have anything to do with who gets the tax bill. And no way to make it happen.
Some of it was itemized bill, just in my district.
Is that right?
Because on here today, I drove around and went. And where I could, I did a count on how many people.
You set the rate.
A lot of money, and nobody transient contractors that are in this county doing work.
It's real money.
Every year, and Tim went with me. We had a list, your four days, wasn't it, 11 contractors in the county now were here. None of them were getting billed for the equipment that was here on January the 1st. Some of it was an itemized bill, just in my district. Because on New Year's Day, I drove around and listed all the big orders. And where I could, I did a count on how many people. It added up to a lot of money, and nobody seems to realize that. Taking that money, leaving the county with it. It's real money, they're not paying the taxes. It's a free ride. Later, I guess, we're got to under 200. Well, three contractors in the county now working on the new power line.
There was over 50 excavators sitting in cranes setting up the camps on January the 1st. Phillips and Jordan, cranes.
Or whether it's the power line, not core, whether orders, or the VDOT contractors. All of them from out of very well funded companies. They're here doing work, just taking that money, leaving the county with it. And they're not paying the taxes. The average excavator, I guess, is worth $200,000. You said they're counting. That's right. All the snow removal equipment that's down there on the patent. And it's just that way with everything goes on, whether it's a gas line, that old state. Or whether it's a power line, or whether it's the VDOT contractors that are here from out of town, out of county. So I don't know why I'm talking about all that. Because if we did an inventory of what else, not we got it in county.
Well, and what Steve was saying, I mean, last year, when you increased personal property tax, that was the reason, to spread that net a little bit wider. But it doesn't.
That's right.
What I'm seeing is it's not working. Same people that are paying their property tax are paying the personal, or their real estate tax are paying their personal property tax.
Full of other people's equipment that they use for snow removal. They pay taxes.
I do know that the DMV stops.
I don't know why I'll be all about that.
I see a lot of people telling me like these.
We can't do anything about it.
Delinquent taxes.
Well, and what Steve was saying, I mean, last year, when you increased personal property tax, that was the reasoning, to spread that net a little bit wider. But it doesn't, what I'm seeing is it's not working. It's the same people that are paying their property tax are paying their personal, or their real estate tax are paying their personal property tax.
Correct.
I do know that the DMV stops has helped a lot. And I see a lot of people coming in with these pink now, because delinquent tax.
Exonerations of all these vehicles coming in within the county.
And I don't know if it's not, if it's up.
They're saying they're not in the county.
From the collections of last year. We'll get a report at the next meeting.
Well, the $30 trash fee. Let me go back to just a second. The complaints I've had, one was, you know, from a gentleman who said that he would be glad to pay the $30 trash fee if he can take his trash out. He, again, was one of those people, and yeah, the longer it goes, the more I'm hearing. Yeah, people who were going to the recycling centers, to the trash, yeah, to put their trash, and everything is full. And they either have to try to climb up on a pickup truck. The other day, I had some old stuff I had to throw away. So the complaints I've had.
Pulled alongside the.
One was, you know, from a gentleman who said that he would be glad to pay the $30 trash fee.
I could throw it over that way.
If he said his trash off.
Yeah. If he can take his trash off when he needs to.
Again, was one of those people.
He'd be glad to pay $30.
Yeah, the longer it goes, the more I'm hearing.
Said that.
Yeah, people who were going To the recycling centers, to the trash, yeah, to put their trash, and everything is full. And they either have to try to climb up on a pickup truck. The other day, I had some old stuff I had to throw away. So I pulled alongside the big box and got up on my toolbox on the truck, and I could throw it over that way. But he said that, I talked to today, if he can take his trash off when he needs to, he'd be glad to pay the $30. I got another email from a lady who said that, if they're going to be taxed for the trash, or is the service going to improve? She said she, because she was talking about that she had gone and had to throw trash over the top, and that
there are people out there,
an elderly person was there, and I explained to her
that we have the low income.
Another lady I talked to today
applied
was, and I told her that she,
so I think the biggest complaint
she would probably qualify for the low income thing.
Went to a funeral Saturday,
put it in place, but she said that she lived on Social Security.
I just want to tell you, I'm by herself. She's got $809 a month.
About the time that she paid
her medicine,
he's from Crockett
and everything like that.
She said she knew $30 a year.
The big concern, our biggest complaint that I have is
away from her. And there are people out there that are not being able,
and I explained
to throw their trash away,
that when they get there, they have to go from one to another thing.
And I think that we talked about this
trying to get
applying the
trash up over the side.
So I think the biggest complaint that I've gotten, besides the guy
who
went to a funeral on Saturday, one guy about stopped me and he said, listen, I just want to tell you, I'm against everything. So
for that community, and a lot of people will dump
me
there.
He's from Crockett. The big concern, our biggest complaint that I have is that
months and doesn't get emptied and put
another. They're not being able to throw their trash away. When they get there, they have to go from one to another to another. And they see older folks trying to get trash up over the side of the boxes.
That's the complaints that I have.
And that was why I asked last meeting about taking at the Apple House. For that community,
replacing some,
a lot of people will dump trash there. Coming down the road from a retreat or going back up, and if we could take that one recycling bin out that sits there for months and months and months and doesn't get emptied, and put another one of those open box containers. I mean, if we can do things like that, that'll improve the service. That's the complaints that I have. Replacing some and then some new ones, yeah.
To add more places like that. I know that'll have a second additional box.
It's in the thing.
I had a taking recycling email.
You don't have to.
One of
when you take more recycling.
She said, quit messing around with junkie tags and decided to real estate.
It means if you take recycling,
they'll take your recycling.
See, now, to me, that's going to cause, I think there are some administrative nightmares with that.
It's in the thing that if you're taking recyclables, you don't have to have a thing. You can take them with recyclables.
See,
it means if you're taking recyclables,
they'll take the recyclables. Several, as far as the trash.
See, now, to me, that's going to cause, I think there are some administrative nightmares with that.
With some of the people in Wytheville say, well, if you're going to charge me, you should come get my trash. I'll add that one in. That's one that I haven't heard been mentioned yet.
Well, in a town, you have an option. You can pay $100 and get yours picked up.
Yeah. I think it's not a free service, and that it's perceived as not an additional.
Mrs. O'Quinn.
I mean, I don't know. For some reason, I think people think it's a free service. It's not
as far as the trash.
But I've heard most of the same complaints everybody else has. The only thing I would add
is that in with some of the people in Wytheville say, well, you know, if you're going to charge me, you should come get my trash.
We got to think about what we're going to have to do, a plaque.
I'll add that one, yes. That's one that I haven't had multiple cards mentioned yet. I've heard that.
Well, in town, you have an option. You can pay $100 and get yours picked up.
I've heard that. What if I have three, you know, pickup truck and a car and I think it's not a free service.
Sticker on my car.
It's perceived as not an additional. I mean, I don't know. For some reason, I think people think it's a free service. It's not a free service. It's paid from general fund money. But, you know, the implementation of a fee just for that, I think will be, I think there'll be some, I mean, then we got to think about what we're going to have to do, a placard, or are you going to do a wall hang? What if I have multiple cars? I've heard that argument. I haven't heard that one mentioned in this forum, but I've heard that. What if I have three, you know, pickup truck and a car, and I stick something in my car, and I don't have my sticker on my car or whatever? Are they going to refuse my? I mean, you know, that's a valid point. So.
How many regular people take more than, I mean, most people have two vehicles. How many people take more than eight tires a year to it?
Eight tires.
More than eight?
I got a fleet of 15 trucks and 75 trailers.
Oh. You're the.
That's another topic for another day.
Yeah, I agree. We have free tire days, but I mean, if that tire day doesn't correspond with them taking them off of their car, then they don't want to keep them.
If you don't buy another set, you go get a ticket.
Well, how many regular people take more than, I mean, most people have two vehicles. How many people take more than eight tires a year to it?
I should take eight tires a year.
More than eight?
I got a fleet of 15 trucks and 75 trailers.
Oh. You're the.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Yeah.
That's another topic for another day.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, if you go to a different recycling center.
Well, if you don't buy another set, then you go get a ticket.
But now, I just put a set of tires on my trailer, and that was eight tires right there. So that means I can't take any tires off my truck, which has got six on it, or the other truck, which has got six on it.
I mean, who keeps up with how many tires you bring?
That's probably as much as.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I mean, if you go to a different recycling center.
All right, if we eliminate the $30, how does that, where do we go from there? So if,
eventually say, you can't bring six tires on my set. I guess really, if you take four today and four next month, there ain't no way they track it. They don't take down license plates. Them old boys will hardly get up out of those lawn chairs when I do.
I don't think that's a problem as much as just.
If it's real dirty or muddy, they'll say, we won't take dirty tires. Mm-hmm.
All right, if we eliminate the $30, how does that, where do we go from there? So that's
around $400,000.
It's $360,000. I guess first they almost start capital.
Now, this budget does not have anything coming out of general fund like we did last year?
You mean reserve fund?
I mean reserve fund. I'm sorry. Yeah.
It already has 125 surplus. I can get 200 if you go to that average, 60 some thousand dollars just by whacking away at the capital improvement. A lot of people don't have that money to take back.
Now, this budget does not have anything coming out of general fund like we did last year?
You mean reserve fund?
I mean reserve fund, I'm sorry.
A lot of people looking that up, looking at my emails. This guy, Billy Martha, sent me an email at one point today that said, it's from John Humphries, and it says, Mr. Humphries cannot be here tonight and ask him if he entered into the record that he opposes the trash permit fee because people will start throwing their trash, dumping it all over the roads, mountains, and in business dumping.
Page 360. Page 361 of the agenda is where the revenue budget is, is that what you're talking about as well?
Yeah. It's 360, find them, go down to surplus. If you discount the...
I thought that we were making changes so we wouldn't take that money out of the surplus. So we're ending up, am I reading it wrong, with taking $1 million more out this time than last year?
Where it says total local funds right above there. When we went back and adjusted all these revenues based on the feeling collected from personal profits, for example.
I thought that we were making changes so we wouldn't take that money out of the surplus. So we're ending up, am I reading it wrong, with taking $1 million more out this time than last year? Okay.
Do we have an estimate on what the carryover from this year's base budget will be?
Okay.
That was the goal.
pretty substantial savings, $200,000. So that's where most of that's coming from. Then we got some other things that we've saved on. My goal is to save $1 million, be honest, get everything, maybe even lay a purchase order to this next budget. It's part of that management cash flow.
I know, hopefully, I can talk to enough people in the general assembly this spring that maybe we can get something changed. But I know it.
Everything y'all said is exactly correct. Elections. It's at the end of the day, I have so much money to make this budget come. It'd be nice if you could raise the family with a raise the wheel tax by 2 cents.
So if we don't do the trash fee, we'll cut out Try to find a little bit. What about the water? That doesn't affect general fund money, I know. Those are kind of three-legged stool that we're talking about. So if we don't do the trash fee, we'll cut out some of the capital improvements or all of the capital improvements. And I think there was nobody here. Well, one person through Gary.
Try to find a little
speak against that. But
what about the water piece?
That's paid for by people using water. I don't have a problem with that. That doesn't affect general
well,
fund
of course,
money, I know.
I object to the
that's
water.
That's kind of three-legged stool.
I don't think I would next year, but I do this year because last year, we raised it in one whack, $7 a month. And now we're raising it another 5%. I think if we had a year in between.
I think that. There was nobody here. Well, one person.
That's
paid for by the people that use the water.
I don't have
a problem with that.
I object to the water increase this year. I don't think I would next year, but I do this year because last year, we raised it in one whack, $7 a month. And now we're raising it another 5%. I think if we had a year in between, and of course I know I'm just one vote, one voice, but I don't like the water increase.
Well, I haven't heard.
I've had people complain. We just put water to speak, and we mandated that they hook up, and then now you can come back a year or so. I guess we mandated they hooked up and we raised their water bills, and then we're going to come back again and raise again. So, they're going to hook up.
Yeah, but with all the positive publicity, especially with Barron Springs, are they really fussy?
Water is the best part of the job.
I went back and changed.
You like drinking water. I heard an interesting
report yesterday about banks' non-interest income, which a lot of it comes from overdraft fees, but when the gas prices went down, I mean, there was less cost, you know, in terms of people buying gas, and people had overdrew less because they had more money in their pocket.
Well, I complain, but it don't do no good.
But, I mean, you know, you hear a lot of people out there saying,
you like drinking water.
But the gas piece, it really impacts a lot more than what...
You know, I heard an interesting... This has nothing... I heard an interesting...
Impacts a lot of things.
Report yesterday about banks' non-interest income, which a lot of it comes from overdraft fees, but when the gas prices went down, I mean, there was less cost, you know, in terms of people buying gas, and people had overdrew less because they had more money in their pocket to do what... But, I mean, you know, you hear a lot of people out there saying, well, you know, but the gas piece, it really impacts a lot more than what, I mean, impacts your business tremendously, but impacts a lot of things that outside of just what you might think.
The good thing on the horizon is next week, the sales commission will have $100 million in power
service. Well, and I'm always from an optimistic standpoint, I mean, we still have the opportunity for economic development. And we haven't, I know that it's not a guarantee, but there's an opportunity there. Right. Well, I mean, there's a lot of counties, they don't have a progress park, they don't have a lot to make more, they don't have, you know, any development on a corridor that runs 7781. I mean, you know, we have some resources that others don't. Well, and I'm always from an optimistic standpoint, I mean, we still have the opportunity for economic development. I mean, we haven't, I know that it's not a guarantee, well, but there's an opportunity there.
As far as the water rates, I haven't had anybody to comment on the water rates to me. And I'm kind of like...
Right.
Well, I mean, there's a lot of counties, they don't have a progress park, they don't have a lot to make more, they don't have, you know, any development on a corridor that runs 7781. I mean, you know, we have some resources.
I do, I pay.
2 years out.
Right.
A large water bill that has grown as my family has grown. So what is everybody kind of...
As far as the water rates, I haven't had anybody comment on the water rates to me.
The water, it seems to be the 30-hour fee.
Already, I mean, the service should pay for itself.
If we could avoid the 30-hour fee.
Well, these days, I may be paying a water bill.
Supporting the other two lines.
So what? I do, I pay. A large water bill that has grown as my family has grown. Can't do it. So what, is everybody kind of the 5 cent real estate tax? I'm not hearing any about, and then the water, it seems to be the 30-hour fee. I mean, I would, if we could avoid the 30-hour fee, I'd support the other two items.
Just playing off the comments here as well, how much work would it be for staff, and what's the time fraction if you propose a 5.5 cent increase?
Can't do it.
Unless you have another public hearing.
We're going to have an advertisement. This is 2 consecutive weeks.
So you're 7 out of time.
You can do that. You make your business.
I'm going to be on Facebook, dude. I mean, I think that's where I'm at. I'll just...
Well, I'm with Artie. I can support the two.
I can support three because it's only 35. And it's worked very good.
You'll be on Facebook, dude.
I mean, I think that's where I'm at. I'll just...
Well, I'm with Artie. I can support the two.
I'm going to be different. I can support three because it's only $30. And it's worth great to do.
I don't, the rest of y'all choke on her. Speak up.
What do you think, boy? Cut teachers, cut teachers.
Cut bus drivers, exactly.
And that'll work?
Well, one clarification. Cal Pike is the best.
I would say I'm against all three because I've heard of things against all three. There's only one, but... We got a balance, but...
So how do we do that? You pay against all three?
Cut teachers, cut teachers.
Cut bus drivers, exactly.
And that'll work?
Well, one clarification. Cal Pike is the best. Almost as tragically, really playing chances. How are we going to collect? Will be added into the tax bill?
No, you're going to come in, so it's kind of running as a utility, just like the water and sewer. You probably... Accounting system, and it's up in the middle of the fall. Could be after June.
Well, they don't have to show up.
Get the first contract, they'll come in and purchase your...
That's what I'm saying. They don't usually come in and pay.
They don't use the... You don't have to use it. You don't have to pay, and you don't have to use the service.
For example, well, there's something to lose. If we run it through the treasury... Number one, nobody's sent, but if it pays, you ran it through the treasury firm, it'd be a colossal failure. But it's got to be a utility firm.
Okay.
That's definitely $30.
How would we get that 50% if something goes up?
Well, they don't have to show up.
But that's what I mean. If they don't choose not to come in and pay.
They don't use the... You don't have to use it. You don't have to pay, and you don't have to use the service.
For example, if you get...
Well, there's some validity.
Well, number one, nobody's down the middle of a rotary, not a pristine firm, and can come down without a permit. So, our number nine in town's coming to get the primary house. So, they'll pay $30. There's 7,000 houses with me. There's 7,000 people. If you come by, that's what just happens. Except they want trash. 500 people buy it for $100 a year. I think 3,000. The Wythe people are probably the town of the rotary lady going to come. Get there, which is okay. I mean, you're in out in Canada, you're going to get out of it.
That's okay, yeah.
He's in the car, he goes to talk about it. He goes to order five, go get the trash. I'll buy it right here. And I can take a pickup truck load for a week. My mom's there, she's not here, so I'll just pick her trash up there. And you won't get, they saw another 3,000 people because they'll have found a way to circumvent, which is okay. I mean, if Gary House wants to do that, that's the right thing. Gary, I'm going to do that.
That's okay, yeah.
But he's in the car, he goes to talk about it. He goes to charge five and go get their trash. Gene, I hear them saying that when they had, here we saw when they got rid of sticker, there's less people pay their license. But you know, most people, I think, can, are going to do the right thing. They have to have a fee, it's decal, a permit, those are trash, where they'll come get them. And they may, and probably from a dollar point of view, it doesn't have to start July 1st. I mean, you make it January 1st, so your sticker just says 2016.
Tax will be sometime. I just want to see if it's broken, it's what everybody's saying, there's a return. Carroll County, if you take the trash off, you got a day in that lane, so you have a property fix. Or they're probably done snowed.
I have a question for you, you brought up a point about.
Land is well paid, the quarterly fee, it's not picking that. You see it up some land.
But is part of that also.
From a dollar point of view, it doesn't have to start July 1st. I mean, you make it January 1st, so your sticker just says 2016.
Tax will be sometime.
September, October, November, last year.
It'll be sometime.
Sam could put a D and B stop on it, so I didn't pay after December.
Can't happen, so I mean, probably February.
If I haven't paid, nobody's, you know, it ain't no big deal. I mean, I think about my license, whatever. If they come November, when I go get the land, then I'm gonna have to. But is part of that also to the fact that people, I mean, if I bought my tags or my license renewed or whatever, if I did it.
Do you think there is gonna be more like that?
September or October or November of last year. Sam couldn't put a, he couldn't put a D and B stop on it until I didn't pay after December. So I mean, if I haven't paid.
Well, I just think the biggest thing is what hurt.
It ain't no big deal. I mean, I still got my license.
Vehicles laying, it's underrated.
If they come November, when I go get the tag, then I'm gonna have to pay. Or else I'm gonna run around with no tags. But I mean, do you think there is gonna be more like that, that we will collect more from something like that?
I think eventually people will get the message, but it's a long draw out. You got your license 2 years, a lot of people buy tags for 2 years.
Well, I just think the biggest thing is what hurt is the vehicles they have underrated. These people are coming in that says they don't have them.
It's an amazing thing. This lady.
How many of those cars have been underrated?
Gee, did we actually collect on the check?
And how many have been added?
This is personal.
They get
23 licenses.
That's what I'd like.
23, Joe?
Well, I mean, what we, yeah, what we collected is less than.
Cars, actually, property license, and you're not selling parts. And this is the last time we're here, Brian.
But I would like to know, Ken, you're talking about the cars.
I'm just talking, I'm talking about not the license fee, the personal property tax on.
How many of those cars have been exonerated? Did we actually collect taxes from beforehand? And how many have been added that we didn't have? That's what I'd like to know.
Well, I mean,
what we, I just don't understand how.
What we've collected, it's less than have at many vehicles titled in this county.
Actually paid license fees.
You know, and then come up, nobody has that vehicle. I'm just talking, I'm talking about not the license fee, the personal property tax on the vehicles.
Right.
Well, you know, I don't, I just don't understand how you can have that, DMV can have at many vehicles titled in this county. You know, and then come up, nobody has that vehicle.
And I don't think we should, because I mean, we've got people that own property, but a little piece of property here, but I don't know if they live somewhere.
They give burn for $58,000 to write it down here.
Send a bill to Carroll County.
That's what I was gonna say. I mean, we didn't stipulate that they had to pay that $20 fee. And I don't think we should, because I mean, we've got people that own property, own a little piece of property here.
person got out of state life, like, owns property here, or rent property, whatever, we do the concealed carry. We actually had someone come in from Carroll County, get one of the cars, and they just get information where they live. No, I don't live there, I just want a car to the trash.
And we need to send a bill to Carroll County.
Carroll County pays that on the first one, $500.
We had somebody come in here 2 weeks ago, you know, we'll do the person's got out of state life, and like, owns property here, or rent property, and we'll just do the cars. We actually had someone come in from Carroll County, get one of the cars, and they just get the information where I live. No, I don't live there, I just want a car to throw the trash away, that was it. Well, we appreciate you coming and trying to get a car, we don't charge for it, but.
Consensus on trash day, I think we have.
They too, they was working in that thing over there, and they want everybody exactly where they live.
Okay.
I mean, y'all don't regret the tires, or whatever, I bet you didn't get you in here, how many tires you bought.
Well, I can give them guys a bump.
Did we make any consensus?
Well, did we make any? We'll have consensus on the trash fee, I think we have on the other two.
This is a couple things, everybody's only doing it, so just.
Okay.
I mean, maybe not everybody's, but in general.
No trash fee.
So we gotta get Salel and that staff some direction on that, how to talk about that, all that. Because we gotta, we've done it how much we're meeting.
Well, we're gonna have to meet again, aren't we, sometime?
This is a couple things, everybody's request for additional money, just gotta go. That's first, that's not the budget, that just adds more deficit to the whole bank.
Acceptable money for who you. That was contingent on the.
With this capital improvement, which is not gonna be easy.
But that amount is good.
Next thing I'm gonna do is, we just won't open rural treatment plant, or coal pool, or any of that stuff, not essential, it's funded, just has to go away. We just put brand new pumps in, so they'll last probably 3 years. It's kind of choices, we're gonna make, but two brand new pumps on that.
Well, that capital money for the pool.
Okay.
That was contingent on the.
I don't like the trash thing.
DGIF anyway.
And I don't know how to do it so that it's user-friendly exactly. I can go with the 5 cents. If I have to, can go with the, with the trash fee. Don't like the, you know, the water rates. But, you know, when we start cutting out all the extra stuff, you see, one thing that, you know, I was gonna bring up.
I'll still bring it up.
Is,
I don't like the trash thing.
Worcester Fair Association.
And I don't know how to do it.
And I know, Swell, you said it was user-friendly, exactly.
Don't think it's that, I think it's an issue of fairness, I still don't understand.
I can go with the 5 cents.
$5,000.
If I have to, can go with the.
And give nothing to.
With the trash fee.
Don't like the, you know, the water rates.
About every, you know, every week. But, you know, when we start cutting out all the extra stuff, you see, one thing that, you know, I was gonna bring up. I'll still bring it up, is Roy Treat Fair Association. I still, and I know, Swell, you said it was regionalistic, and I don't think it's that. I think it's an issue of fairness. I still don't understand how we can give $5,000 to Chautauqua and give nothing to Roy Treat Fair Association when they have something going on just about every, you know, every weekend.
But at least, whatever this is, 75 acres, zero dollars.
what is the real value of the EC 75 prime ammunition? I'll tell you what I'm paying for a lease, you know, 50 acres, but I mean, it's a lot more than they've asked for a free. Plus, Chautauqua is completely pillaged, convinced. They charge admission fee to everything.
Take our money, use it.
So, you know, it's not like they can be apples to apples. Give them the land and then got, see where something you go to free. You got an attendance, so they are getting the contribution, whatever it is. Most clients, thousands of people are better over there. Last year, we put money into that.
And I understand we disagree on that. I mean, I know what you're saying. I understand that. But, you know, we're trying to encourage, and I know that the county owns that and we lease it to them for nothing. And I understand all that, but we're also trying to encourage, you know, not only tourism, but activity in the county and things like that. And there's a group right now with the Retreat Fair Association is really trying to do that, I think. I'd like for the county. I understand we disagree on that. I mean, I know what you're saying. I understand that. But we're trying to encourage, and I know that the county owns that and we lease it to them for nothing. And I understand all that, but we're also trying to encourage, you know, not only tourism, but activity in the county and things like that. And there's a group right now with the Retreat Fair Association is really trying to do that, I think. I'd like for the county not just to support it in spirit, but support it with some dollars. This year, over the 4th of July, or that weekend, I guess. What is the 4th on what?
Saturday.
So on Friday and Saturday.
Not the pillars.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think, you know, if any money is given to them, it, to me, it should come out of the tourism. The carryover was from the tourism committee last year. We had any carryover money.
Right. And they're doing it again this year. Over the 4th of July, or that weekend, I guess. What is the 4th on what?
Saturday.
So on Friday and Saturday.
Not the pillars.
No, we had $80,000 in there for the signs on that.
Well, I think, you know, if any money is given to them, to me, it should come out of the tourism money. And I don't know what the carryover was for the tourism committee last year.
Cut that. If we had any carryover money out of it.
I think that's where the money should come from.
I don't have any objection to that.
So I don't know, we had $80,000 in there for the signs on the interstate. Do we have to, if we done, that was 4 signs, we done cut that in half and done just 2 signs on 81. That still, I mean, does that cut that in half
for being there? Well, I agree with you there. If they don't take them down, I mean, it's people actually go pull in there and stop if they see a sign that says you go. Over to.
Now, the signs were supposed to be for Stephen Austin Memorial. Okay, I have to ask this.
Well, I agree with you there.
Will we get a payback on $80,000?
Is people
spend $80,000 on that sign? Will we get a payback for people going in there to look at that memorial?
Tell you to be, and you'll be charged. I'm getting down there as fast as I can.
Now, the signs were supposed to be for Stephen Austin Memorial. Okay, I have to ask this. Will we get a payback on $80,000? Spend $80,000 on that sign, will we get a payback to people going in there to look at that memorial? Well, that's, I guess that's my point. If we're talking about things to cut.
I think we have created revenue, but it's not, I think it was created for the town. I mean, that's where the meals and lodging.
Yeah.
I mean, that, they've seen a real increase, you know, as far as lodging and meals.
Well, that's, I guess that's my point. If we're talking about things to cut.
I think we have created revenue, but it's not, I think it was created for the town. I mean, that's where the meals and lodging.
Yeah.
I mean, that, they've seen a real increase, you know, as far as lodging and meals.
But what I would say is if we cut anything, I would be very much in favor of cutting that out of the budget before we cut anything to hurt citizens in Wythe County.
Well, but we can't, that tourism money can only be used for certain things.
But what I would say is if we cut anything, I would be very much in favor of cutting that out of the budget before we cut anything to hurt citizens in Wythe County.
Well, but we can't, that tourism money can only be used for certain things.
But I like for it to be massaged so that it helps people here today, you know. Well, yeah, but I like for it to be massaged so that it helps people here today, you know.
I right to pick up with Richard, but I think those signs might have been put up from, you know, the local approval, and maybe it never went to Richard, or maybe that's a decision to be made in their signs, and I'm still accommodating to the park people, but it's there.
You're probably 99.9% correct.
If we'd asked them to do it, it would have had to come to the attorney general's office, see if they could put them up out. But I think they can come down the same way that we know, seeing anyway, with the right pictures, and let's not do this. Obviously, the outcry that somebody shared about Roman Health building design, it works. The name comes up, you put it back against the red sign, and I was gonna hurt Corey's business.
Land man.
But I don't think it would ever run a ticket anyway, unless it was one of two game wardens. It's in the policy of DGIF, I doubt it. But we need to go see them anyway and see if they're gonna redo the lease.
So you're saying you think he'll give us another lease?
Talk to somebody different. That unlike a break sign. If the name comes to you, who's the guy in the room?
It's the land manager that came to me, he's gone again.
It wasn't Phil Lamb.
Has anybody changed their mind on the trash fee except for Gary? So you're saying you think he'll give us another lease?
I've done him a lot of favors. He was retired a long time ago. We won't stay that here, I agree.
Has anybody changed their mind on the trash fee except for Gary?
I was for it all along, so no one had to change their mind.
All you need is two more votes, and we can do what we want to.
Thank you, Joe. I'm not gonna vote against the budget. And that's just remember, your vote for about $76,000, said you was gonna get schools, you can't get the ordinance. It's just in the budget, additional to make whole this whole.
Yeah, 'cause I found out they wouldn't let me vote line item. We don't have no line item vote.
Well, I mean, I think that's a good point. Are you gonna vote down on the whole?
I'm not gonna vote that budget, but include that, 'cause it's now, with that trash.
And that's what you're really doing, is you're voting for the budget, and then you're voting for the walk. Well, you gotta adopt an ordinance.
Which was very clear, whatever love.
That's the real, if it's just in the budget.
Yeah, 'cause I found out they wouldn't let me vote line item. We don't have no line item vote.
Well, I mean, I think that's a good point, if you vote against me, are you gonna vote down on the whole budget? 'Cause that budget's gonna include that, as it is now, include that trash fee, because.
Well, we've had a public hearing on all three of them.
Well, that's just like mine, I mean, I voted against the 6-year plan, but then I voted for the budget solution, saying that you got a home, you got a vote for the tax rate, right?
I mean, thank you, that tax increase, I mean, I just think mileage makes the way, and the water rates are set.
See, I guess what my.
If I'm gonna vote for a budget for the trash fee, but if you vote against the trash fee, you're not saying my vote for the budget.
That's my, you got one vote.
I'm saying I'm voting for the budget. I'm saying trash fee, that trash fee is included in here.
Well, we've had a public hearing on all three of them.
I mean, again, that's just like mine, I mean, I voted against the 6-year plan, and if you vote on those three words.
We want to vote those on.
Then, I mean, when you come to budget, I mean, you're not more.
I mean, thank you, that.
We've already lost that vote, too. I'm just saying my position would be.
Well, I mean,
my thing, we gotta get.
See, I guess what my, what I'm.
If I'm gonna vote for a budget with a trash payment, I'm gonna vote for the trash. I'm saying by voting for the budget, that's my, if I'm saying I'm voting for this budget, I'm saying that that trash fee's included in here.
I guess the way I'm looking at it, I mean, I guess it depends on how you vote. You vote on those three first, and you lose one of those.
Your vote on those, so.
Then, I mean, you have to vote for the budget, when you come to the budget.
You can vote for a balanced budget, you don't.
You've already lost that vote, so it's gone, it's behind you.
I guess the layman's, what I mean, my thing, we gotta get the trash fee directional.
We can't vote against it, it'd be like.
You can't vote for an unbalanced budget.
No.
Right.
So something's gotta be cut if we don't agree to one of these two.
Yeah, it's not essential.
Right.
But if the majority agrees to all three.
It's minor manipulation after that.
Then, I mean, you've already lost your vote on those, so when it comes time to vote for the budget, you either vote for a balanced budget or you don't, I mean.
I mean, to me, I guess the layman's, or what I'm coming from, if you're not gonna vote for the trash fee, then you gotta increase the cuts. What Sal's saying is the cuts are gonna be capital improvements, up to including closing, not opening the pool.
Anything that's not essential is gonna.
And so the decision.
We don't have a lot.
I'm just saying, the decision I'm making is, so there's people upset about the trash fee. You either, I mean, they're gonna vote for a budget that's cutting all that stuff, vote against trash fee. Or vote for the budget as it's been presented and vote for the trash fee. Whether you like the trash fee or not.
Right.
Nobody, it's just like saying, well, I don't like increasing taxes, well, we all agree that we would, we see the need for it, we don't see anything.
Yeah, I got a phone call about that too.
I think if we cut, we start cutting certain things, you get more problems about.
We don't have a lot.
We're gonna be upset.
Yeah, well, okay, I'm not gonna.
But there's gonna be other people upset about, I mean, if you don't have an order to.
Or the campground down.
There's gonna be a lot of people upset about that.
Or a couple of things that I'd like to see added back into the budget, so.
So, I mean, you know.
Campground was full, and we had a lot of blue with kids.
Yeah, I got a phone call about that too. Oh, I don't like the trash fee.
I guess would be, is if you get more.
I don't like any of this, but.
Well, okay, I'm not gonna.
I mean, we can't just sit here.
Or the.
That's right.
Or the campground down.
Wish we had $2 or $3 million.
Or a couple of things.
If I vote for the trash.
That I'd like to see added back into the budget, so.
Fair association.
Well, when I said something, I said, Sal, tell me what happens if we don't take trash fee out. You said.
Oh, I don't like the trash fee.
I don't either.
I don't know anybody.
I don't like any of this, but.
If I vote for the budget.
I mean, we have to do what we have to do. I mean, we can't just sit here and wish we had $2 or $3 million that we don't have.
If I vote for the trash fee, surely I can get some money for work treat, fair association.
Well, when I said.
Left wing side.
If I vote for the budget, personally, if I vote for the trash fee and water, but water's a completely separate thing, but it's not. If you don't vote for the water, you don't produce water, you compound the budget problem. So to me, if you vote for the budget, in my opinion, I would vote for everything.
I say, you've heard this side before.
Yeah, the right wing side.
Let's hear from the left wing side of here.
That school request can be, I mean, it can be moved down the road a little farther than what it is now. We go out to look at where the money's gonna come from.
I
know it's going to cost us big money next year. Where is that money going to come from next year? We don't have something good happening in park. Industrial development, we're going to be in deeper hot water next year because of the school request. I believe that.
Well, I mean, that school request can be, I mean, it can be moved down the road a little farther than what it is now. That's, we go out to look at where the money's going to come from.
But Joe, that money is not in next year's budget. We don't have the money invested in the budget. So you have this meeting to decide what's going on, how they're going to do this. That's the reason you've got a June 23rd meeting.
And it's shaky, isn't it? Well, I talked to Anthony Sykes, who's the principal of the vocational school or technical school or whatever we call now, and he said that the counselors were trying to sign people up, but he said it just wasn't going very well.
But how about the 76,000?
And it's shaky, isn't it?
It's real shaky.
The money's still there. The extra money's there for his operating budget.
Well, I talked to Anthony Sykes, who's the principal of the vocational school or technical school or whatever we call it now. And he said that the counselors were trying to sign people up, but he said it just wasn't going very well.
But how about the 76,000?
The EMS program was in the budget. In that position,
there was a position. The money's still there. The extra money's there for his operating budget.
Last year we requested that they consider that the EMS training position out there for EMT.
That's why I
a position and benefits and all in that budget.
So it looks like all three.
If that doesn't go, that should make up this shortfall.
With the no vote on the water,
they wouldn't need that. No.
The 76,000 that Dr. Freeman asked for.
I only do so much for retreat fairs.
But school they didn't have a
good point.
That's
what I understood.
So it looks like all three is going to be implemented.
So basically, we spent 2 hours on it.
With the no vote on the water.
We've had some good
times. That won't happen either. Twist your arm.
I only do so much for retreat fairs.
Good point.
Good point there.
When is this new superintendent, he gonna be on the major quail?
Yes.
Yes.
I understand.
How much was Carolyn King's on?
So basically, we spent 2 hours and we haven't changed anything. We've had some good conversations.
And I'm adding money back to her, but.
I've had two requests. The circuit court judge has requested his $12,000 to keep his assistant. Bradford's still paying her quail. And how much was Carolyn King's on education and travel?
Well, this is what I'm gonna say about Carolyn. If you change her budget and add her money to give it, then I'm adding money back to her budget in the county, just some adding money for travel. Because we cut everybody's travel budget for education and continuing. And we've got people that are doing it on their own money to do it. She can't do it on her own. It's not a requiring thing now. We've got a electoral board. I guess I'm just gonna make a stand today. We're gonna cut, give her her money for education. My money's spread back in for education and everyone of my people. What's fair is fair. We gave everybody, including you guys.
Somebody from the left all worked.
This amount of money, travel and education. If you want to pay above.
What they've always told us, that somebody could lead us.
Spend a little bit of your own time and energy and money to do it. Do think fair is fair. Paying my salary to go. Providing the vehicle, council needs. For years, we've never, the assistant registrar, it's never been a part of that travel position.
Does somebody from the left all worked to come in and cover their office? Because that's what the regulations say, and what they've always told us, was somebody was supposed to be there every day.
But they've got, we've negotiated, well, do think fair is fair. Not let, I think, water operators, everybody get it.
Y'all will support.
I don't see any difference.
I agree with them down there, what we're doing. I'll do that.
I think you have to be that system.
I don't want to go down there and.
Yeah, but I can't even work for everybody.
Judge calls, you guys, I really want.
All the judges must, but can't you just think it must have a purpose for this movie?
On that.
What we get for, well, if y'all care, when we negotiate what we do in his office out of that 50, I'll take it 12 out of that 50. And y'all will support what, it's pretty good. I agree with them down there, what we do in his office. I'll do that. As long as y'all support that, I'm fine. I don't have a problem doing it. I don't wanna go down there.
Well, good show after all. I mean, he's not.
Judge calls, you guys.
He's not one to spend lavishly on stuff like that.
Maple or something, so we don't have a credit card.
On that.
What we did for Lee Harrell. Wayne's going. It's pretty good. As long as y'all support that, I'm fine with it. I don't have a problem doing things.
Well, good show after all. I mean, he's not one to spend lavishly on stuff like that.
I've renovated more courts. You can do a lot for a $50,000 for a bit of people to read payment.
Well, I'll just put it in that way. This is the amount of money you got to renovate your office.
Next guy will be there building the bookcases and all that stuff.
Now, this is just his office. That can wait.
You're not doing anything.
Can we do it? That's next. We probably can do it for $35,000. We just got enough money in the courthouse.
Brutal with that.
Discussion. And then next year.
Well, I'll just put it to him that way. This is the amount of money you got to renovate your office.
And when we get started, the next guy will be down jail.
Well, was part of that plan renovating those seats or adding any?
No.
No, this is...
Just his office.
Just his office. That can wait.
Still not doing anything before.
Can I request money for Rotary Fair Association?
We've got enough.
Well, I mean, certainly I know I can request it.
Well, like I say, I think it needs to come out of the tourism budget.
Fine with that.
I would agree with that. And I don't know if the refund out of those chairs.
Oh, no. I'm not...
Because my argument is like Swell with all that said, or all that. They are getting money from us. They keep saying, y'all don't give us anything, y'all don't give us anything, but they have a place, y'all have a fair end, so yes.
Right, and I wasn't advocating...
Can I request money for Rotary Fair Association?
$10,000. No. Well, I mean, certainly I know I can request it.
Like I say, I think it needs to come out of the tourism.
Between 25 and 5? Fine with that. I mean,
I don't know.
Do what? Oh, no. I'm not...
Five would be great, but I'll take anything that, you know, we can get for...
They are getting money from us. They keep saying, y'all don't give us anything, but they have a place to have a fair end, so yes, the county...
Right, I wasn't advocating, you know, $10,000. No.
Well, just how much are you asking? Five?
Yeah, between, yeah, 25 and 5. I mean, do what?
25.
Well, I mean, yeah, 5 would be great, but I'll take anything that, you know, we can get for them.
Yeah, I agree with that.
You didn't care the words when we invested in a failure.
But
we'll invest one more time and see if they can make it work.
If we go on flat fund, what we flat funded them last year.
We've got a tremendous leader on board now, and I know we'll make it work.
What we should say to them, and I'll say this, they cannot segregate their fuel account. Make us pay for fuel. We had a request for some fuel for separately. I'm a little bit remembering. We had a request from the Smith for a private board commission for the construction. That's not right. What I understand...
No, it should be put on and...
You want to allocate with any of that money. I think we need to send that message.
But...
Fuel sales and everything.
We go on flat fund what we flat funded them last year, what we give them last year. We're not cutting the...
What we should say to them, and I'll say this...
Set up another meeting with Mary.
They cannot segregate their fuel. Make us pay for the fuel, and then keep the dollars that they sell the fuel for separately. Fund projects for private individuals.
I mean, it's...
We upgraded...
No, it should be put on and on.
And I think we need to send that message. If it's a full operation, you put your fuel...
I mean, something like that would want to have a consensus on all change and tell them.
I think everybody will agree that.
Do we need to set up another meeting with Marion and discuss that?
Get the other two.
Smith?
I agree with you. I think it should be counted with everything else and not put aside.
I mean, it's...
Smith, the administrator, is sick.
It's up.
As soon as he gets back, I'll say that he's...
I mean, something like that, we're going to have a consensus on all of the change and tell them.
I think everybody...
Anything else you might want to discuss? Well, they just want out four.
In a way, I can see...
Get the other two.
But I agree with you. I think it should be counted in with everything else and not put aside.
Where's this one? You waver.
Now, talk about it.
Heads up.
And the bees.
And I don't know what she's supposed to get her being over. I guess she's going to run in there and ask her, is she certified?
Anything else you might want to discuss?
I have a quick...
How
Hayes' office, Chelsea, Chelsea.
In a way, I could see that it would benefit. Well, what I was thinking, after she did all the asphalt, it's just something that happened today. When I went down there to train and stuff, she's not an over.
Once every 4 years.
Something she needs to. I mean, I thought about it at first, and I thought, well, you know, everything's got to be notarized when you take it in there, so maybe she ought to be. And I don't know what it would cost to get her to be a notary.
I guess the question is, maybe we need to ask her, can she certify and also notarize?
There's two notaries in the sheriff's department.
In Hayden's office, Chelsea, Chelsea notarized mine.
Well, I mean, what I was thinking afterwards, I thought, well, how often do you have to go in there?
What was her?
Have it notarized, you know, for being a.
Once every 4 years.
So definitely you can notarize it and certify. I mean, that's.
I'd say you're right.
I mean, one person doing two places. Yeah, different things.
I had Martha notarize everything, I had Tess, a lot of sign off. If I could remember my number today, Jean, I would certify.
So I think it happened.
It worked out with the sheriff's office, and they didn't lock me up, they let me back out.
I guess.
What was her character? Do you remember ballpark, what's the asphalt, go to that?
Improve some form this year. 2250. Improve everything.
For two of them.
For that one training session, track.
Well, they may be like the school, they might spend a little more, they might be able to find.
Whatever the number was.
I'm trying to tag them in for it, but can we set aside part of the.
No, I think it happened when he wrote it in the letter. They changed.
We're doing those, they could be in mail, supposed to be working them. I guess they save it next year and change it. We've been through those if they got. We approved some form this year. We done approved everything that was asked, we approved his purchase for that one training session that I tried. It's $1,200. Whatever the number was.
I'm trying to take it in for it. Can we set aside part of the.
We're just going to take that.
Money for the voting machine last year and the votes last year.
We're doing those, they could be in mail.
Okay. Are we going to meet the week of the 22nd to the 26th?
Sheriff, that's how we decided to do it.
Well, I know that, but did we set aside $50,000 last year?
We talked about it, but we decided to do that lease purchase.
Yeah, but if the 50.
That's Mike's contract, yes.
No.
It is $30,000.
What are we going to do with that $50,000?
We were just going to take the $50,000, we never set aside anything.
What Mike's contract, see, oh.
We were just going to take that out of the general fund.
Okay.
It's got ECN and a bunch of.
Okay, are we going to meet the week of the 22nd to the 26th?
The sheriff called me and wrote me a letter and said that he wanted to return the pay budget. My comment to him was if he wanted to pay for that police activity fund, I'd push back off. That's how it went.
That's the maintenance contracts he asked me about.
My opinion is to put it back.
He said it's $30,000.
Yep. It's got $1,000,000.
I don't know. What maintenance contracts is he talking about?
We're all actively looking.
He's got ECN and a bunch of other things that I've looked a couple of times. He gave me a list of my hard work on it. But then anyway, that's basically my response. If you want to pay for it, they're essential, I think. We'll take that PAA. He's not one of the, let's have a round. And I'll take it different. So my intent is to put it back in, pay for the PAA. He's got $1,000,000, maintenance secret. I'd be taking 30% instead of 20%.
We're all actively looking for vans.
I've looked a couple of times to say that I put some hard work on it.
Do we need to meet before the week?
Probably be misleading you, I've been listening to this, most of my work, something we have to put back. One of my things was just laying in here, just bringing it up.
You know what he said, if I don't get a van, we're going to expense with.
Well, that will be when we adopt the budget on the 30th.
Can we just recess until 29th? I guess I could have a van secretly paid out the PAA.
Okay.
Newberry had to have
before the week of the last meeting.
Now, we'll send all this to you or something. We didn't look back from tonight. If you want, just bring it up. There'll be things that somebody asked you wouldn't need to talk about before.
Well, that will be when we adopt the budget on the 30th.
Can we just recess to the 29th? Got to get about an hour before the joint meeting.
Okay.
And run through this thing, anticipated savings for this.
You going to be here or you going to be there?
Next month, right here.
What time on the 29th?
6:30.
5:30, so it won't take long, but we need to look at it and talk about it.
Truck that we said.
Because there'll be something that somebody asked you that we need to talk about.
I've had some emails, so I just wanted to ask you some questions. Does it need to be inspected by truck?
So we got to get it done by our closeout, get any of your little water, we'll send you the anticipated savings from this year's budget.
Who does the Blacksburg administration need to contact?
Is there anything else? Anything else?
We said earlier that we.
If not, we're in recess until June 29th at 5:30 PM.
Does it need to be inspected by truck mechanic or do you want it inspected by our pump, no water, anything like that?
Truck mechanic.
Okay. Next is who does the Blacksburg administration need to contact to get involved?
You, Mark or me, I'll send them an email. I will see it tomorrow night.
All right. Thank you.
Anything else? If not, we're in recess until June the 29th at 5:30 PM.
Really, we've been on overtime.